Just the men's mass start race to conclude business here at the FISU World University Speed Skating Championships in Northern Italy. We were due to have 17 men at the start line, but it looks like that's been reduced. Alexei Gorshkov of Russia, and not surprised to hear that Konrad Nozsch of Hungary have decided they're going to dip out of this 16 laps. So let's take a look at what we have left. 15 races to go, so it's going to be pretty congested out there. And moving down through the start list, plenty of names that we've already seen in action during the course of this week. Athletes to keep an eye on, well, Bugatti and Giotto from Italy should be strong. Hager, also good when it comes to mass starts. We've seen how good he is as a sprinter over the shorter distances, but pretty comfortable as well when it comes to the 16 lappers. Now, with the fog closing in, we're gonna really have to keep our eyes peeled to try and see these athletes as they move around through the track. But I wouldn't be surprised if we get a group moving away fairly early. We've got some quality athletes in here, and I think they will back themselves. They certainly won't want to be caught up in any traffic and have any early problems. So slightly quicker, slightly more urgency than that very slow tactical start we saw from the women. They won't be flying just yet. Ooh, little stumble out in front there from the man with the number one on the side of his safety helmet, Wojciech Suit. Suit having a little look around to see who else would like to come through and pick up some work at the front. Anton Kapustin is happy to oblige for Belarus. And just a little injection of pace there from number nine, Vasily Melnikov of Russia. So hyper-tactical, you'll see those little injections of pace, you'll see little false breaks, you'll get all the athletes trying to play with each other's minds as they move around this track. And then you'll get the real break, the real pace. Klev Astapu of Belarus moving temporarily into that top spot, but quickly usurped by Daniel Niero of Italy. Niero, another name that you've got to keep an eye on. Keep an eye on as well Marcin Bacinek. He's had a good championship so far. And Heidegger, the other Austrian. The guy's very, very capable of pace. First 5 points then on offer as we move towards the opening sprint of three before we get to the big last lap sprint where the big points are earned. So this is 5-3-1 for first, second, third. And the first sprint. We'll have to wait for confirmation to see if it is Soot that claims it. And we'll see if he decides to keep his pace going. No, he doesn't. Just glides through the line. So 5 points in the bank, I think, for Soot. Confirmed. Niero with three, Bugatti with one. Those points can be rather elementary when it comes to the end of the race. Well, we do have some movement at the front of the field. Bugatti and Niero have gone for Italy by the looks of it. Giotto not far behind them. Now Bugatti, genuine quality as a mass start racer. He's in the number 10 helmet in third position. And making sure that this break doesn't actually happen with any real impetus. Looks like the Dutchman Leitenberg, but I'll confirm that for you when we get sufficiently out of the fog to be able to do so. Well, mass starts are never easy to call, but less so when visibility is like this. It is the number three helmet then. Ronald Leitenberg of the Netherlands. So nine laps to go. Just under the halfway mark. From here, I fancy Bugari to keep this ramped up sufficiently to cause a real problem for the chasing pack. At the moment, content to work in there though. With his compatriot, Niero. Yes, it is Daniel Niero, number 12. Leitenberg, number 3. Now, are they going to keep this going? Niero takes the 5, Bugari the 3, Leitenberg the 1. Are they going to keep this going, or are they going to relax back in? That's a big, long look over his shoulder from Bugari. Bugari happy to let this pack back to them, and once again injects just a little bit of pace. Interesting tactically here. David Giotto now taking over the workload for the Italians. So Giotto it is from Linus Heidegger. Still no showing as yet from Armin Hager. He's kept himself in the pack. Bacinek is in the pack. After that early bit of promise from Melnikov, he seems to have faded a little. From Sutt's point of view, he is completely out of the picture now, dropping further and further behind. So Giotto through the split at 5:34.91 with the lead. Heidegger just behind him. This race building very nicely indeed. And if it stays this congested, we are going to see a massive build to that sprint. Giotto, a little look across to the coaches with 5 laps to go. You need as much information as you can glean. Still no separation, but Giotto is very cleverly not allowing the pace to settle down to anything too pedestrian. He's moving a little bit of pace in there. And Riccardo Bugari now ghosts back into second position with Armin Hager. First showing we've seen from the diminutive Austrian in the number 15 helmet. He is just moving in and out of third and fourth along with Heidegger. Heidegger just in front of him. Well, if Hager's there when we hear the bell for the final lap, then that is a man that has serious speed, so keep an eye on him. Bacinek also can be quick. Bacinek in sixth position at the moment in the red and white speed suit of Poland. Just tucking in behind Kapustin of Belarus. Now, another little break here coming round the outside is number 11, Vugdenhill. And Vugdenhill of the Netherlands just injecting that pace, but he's been matched quite comfortably by Giotto. Then another slingshot move. Ivan Sulutkin of Russia takes the gamble. And the guys who know that they don't quite have it in the legs come the end are just trying to get some of this speed away from the really quick men. And this race is heating up very nicely indeed. Now they've caught him. Now this is going to get very interesting indeed. Hager bursts to the front with Bugari tracking him very closely. Hager leading for Austria. Bugari just off the pace, going a little bit wide there, but needs to sort this out. And they're gradually closing the gap now. They've lapped Sutt. He's out of the race. Don't worry about him. This is all about these leading two. Brilliant work from Hager, and they dive for the line. Well, I don't know that Hager has timed that particularly well, and I think he's given it away to Bugari. He has, according to that graphic, he has, and Hager was on for a good result there in terms of the gold medal and just missed timing things. Well, let's hope that's not a real problem for Olof Gerritsen. In this fog, just did not see the incident that meant he went to the ice. And confirmation, Ricardo Bagari beats Haga to the line. Haga, I think, was just a little too relaxed when it came to that final part of the sprint. Bacharek of Poland in third, Niero in fourth, and Heidegger the only other man to pick up a point from the sprint. But a good showing from Austria and a good showing from Italy in that men's mass start. Well, that was a really enjoyable couple of mass start races, something to really mull over and watch. And some young student athletes in there showing maturity beyond their years. Very cool and calm from Bagari. And as we take a little look back at some of the highlights from the 16 laps, we'll hopefully get another look at that finish and you'll see how Haga, as he moves to the line, doesn't quite drive all the way through. That's early work from Surt on the initial sprint. But he was eventually overpowered and lapped. Chasing pack did their job, closed it down. Bagari, for the briefest of moments, along with Niero. And Leitenberg just conducting a mini break, but then they allowed the group back to them. All the time you see Bagari looking over his shoulder, but once that group got back, then Haga got himself in a really good position, and when he made the break for the front on the final lap after the bell, it did look like it was going to be Haga's race. But he looked so casual on the line, just didn't time it, and that allowed Bagari through to take the gold. Fantastic stuff.
University Championships. FISU, today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.